welcome. You have activated all systems. Deactivation is not an option. You must find the truth. Remember, not everything is what it seems. If you don't stand for something, you might fall for anything. The end is where we begin.
We are the choice, we are the strength. inside that I could not control.
Celebrate their super seniors. They asked me to tell them we love you, Bree, Abby, and Kara. Much love.
Yeah. Step into the 2A regional soccer finals on the pitch today. Both of our area regional finals featuring Central State 8 matchups. We start in Jacksonville, where the Crimsons were facing the Glenwood Titans second half, and Jalen Keene, a wall between the pipes this afternoon. Abby Julin denied. Then Kayla Torrey making a run for the Titans, but again, Keene comes up with the stop to keep him off the board. Second half, 8 minutes to go. Glenwood finally strikes. Abby Clintworth gets just enough of the ball off her head to put it in the back of the net. Glenwood goes on to get the 2-0 win. With a tough sectional semifinal, the Titans facing the defending 2A state champions, Troy Triad. Glenwood hoping to reach the sectional final for the first time in 3 years. Late in the first half, Abby Clintworth finds Kelly Graves. The freshman flicks it over the keeper in for the goal, 2-0. Glenwood on top. Second half, Triad's Alyssa Patterson gets behind the defense, chips it over the goalie, cuts Glenwood's lead down to just 1. Under 15 to go, and Ashley Musgrove from outside the box. It is in the corner and sneaks through for the goal. Glenwood is headed to the sectional final, winning 3-1.
Well, in the playoffs, sometimes it's just a grinded out game. I mean, Triad, with all their experience, state champs last year on their own field, we knew it was going to be tough and played real well, I think, overall.
When we came in the second half, we were kind of rushed and felt kind of panicked, but we pulled it together and we did really good. And we're always a family when we play, and that's what brings us out on top.
Get ready for the SmackDown. Get ready for the SmackDown. How you gonna
SmackDown!
a Central State 8 showdown on the soccer field in Troy. Springfield High and Glenwood battling for a sectional title. It's the second meeting between the two. Glenwood won the first meeting, which was early on in the season. Up for grabs, a trip to the UIS Super Sectional. First half, the Titans will strike first. Abby Julian beats two defenders and gets it just enough on it to put it in the back of the net. 1-0 Glenwood. Springfield High down 3-0 now, looking to generate some offense. Have the corner kick, but no one's there on the backside. Later in the first, still 3-0 Glenwood, and they keep it coming. Julian to Brendan Marshall. This one perfectly plays top shelf. 4-0 Glenwood. Glenwood shuts out Springfield High 7-0. Let's all get wicked. Put your hands in the sky for a one-way ticket. Come on, everybody. Gonna start this party if we turn it to...
Never seen a brother or sister who could cure a disease.
Glenwood soccer team could punch its ticket to the Final Four with a win over Morton tonight. No score in the first. Brendel Marshall at the net. Titans up 1-0 at the half. Second half off the corner kick. Kayla Torrey, she punches it in to make it 2-0, and Glenwood wins 3-0. They will play Normal Friday in the state semifinals.
Glenwood shutting out CSA opponent Springfield High in the sectional final last Friday night. The Titans moving into tonight's super sectional against Morton, with state on the line. Glenwood trying to reach the state tourney for the second time in 4 years. Scoreless game in the first half. Kelly Graves sends it to Brendel Marshall, volleys it and fires it past the keeper for the goal. 1-0 Glenwood. Fans going crazy. Second half, same score on the throw and a little deflection to the backside, and Kayla Torrey slams it home. 2-0 Titans. Glenwood adds another goal and goes on to win 3-0. The Titans going back to the state tournament for the first time since 2009.
we kept them, their chances that they had were minimal and they were outside the box. I mean, that's a very dangerous attacking team, and I was very proud of our defense. I think all year this team has just been getting better and better, and I think we're peaking at the right time.
As a little kid growing up, always playing soccer, I just dreamed of like going to state with my team. Freshman year is awesome for sure to do it, and then, you know, this team, we have the best potential we've had in a while, and I just thought we could really do it, and it came true.
It's unbelievable. It's happy, excited, nervous. I just can't describe it.
Glenwood will play Normal U High Friday at 1 in Naperville. Playing Normal U High in today's state semifinals. Last time the Titans were at the state tournament, 2005. Early second half, 1-0 Glenwood U High's Olivia Crockett trying to equalize. Huge save by Kara Moody, still 1-0 Titans. Shortly after, Abby Julian. The corner kick, freshman Kelly Graves heads it in from far post. Glenwood goes up 2-0. Minutes later, on the throw-in, Cassidy Sheedy, using her head, buries a top right corner, 3-0 Titans. Glenwood shuts out U High, 3-0, will play for a state title. Jeremy Rao is in Naperville.
Well, they did it the Glenwood way, taking advantage of golden scoring opportunities, winning every single loose ball, and pitching their fifth shutout this postseason?
The girls have been playing great defensively, and our defense really starts with our forwards. It's not just the backs and the goalkeeper, and it's got to be a total team effort.
This defense, I mean, they really got my back. They communicate well, and they're always with it, and they really stepped up during the playoffs. Going out as a senior would be really awesome just to get first in state and win it all.
I'm confident that we get some rest and be ready to go. Anything can happen.
With the win, Glenwood has locked up their best finish in the state tournament since 2005 when they took second place, and they now have a chance to win their first ever state championship in girls soccer when they take on Wheaton St. Francis tomorrow at 1 here at North Central College. In Naperville, Jeremy Rao, ABC News Channel 20. Glenwood girls soccer has been to the state tournament four times since 2001, which includes a run to the state championship in 2005 when they took second place. Their opponent in the Class 2A championship, Wheaton St. Francis, who is playing in their first ever state tournament.
The Titans hoping past experience would bring a state title back to Chatham. Early in the game, St. Francis striking first. Sydney Fox finds a wide open Andrea Ravlin. Left corner pocket to make it 1-0 Spartans. Later in the first and not long after, a long free kick by Laura Hunt, gonna bounce off Kelly Graves' back, and Cassidy Sheedy says, "I'm wide open." Back in the net for the goal ties the game at 1-1. For the second half, just 5 minutes to play, we are still tied. Taylor Bucaro with a direct kick. Perfect placement over Kara Moody's head for a goal. And that's the difference. Glenwood falls 2-1 in the state championship.
It's difficult to watch the kids and their reaction because they played so hard today. They did everything we ask of them. We created enough chances to win the game. And to St. Francis' credit, they kept us out. Tomorrow when we wake up, we'll realize what a great season we had, and the girls can be proud of that.
Well, these girls played well beginning of the year till now, and the improvement in our team is tremendous on and off the field. They really came together as a team. Seniors, Abby Julin, Bree Gardner, and Kara Moody were great leaders for us, great examples. And for them to finish their careers with two state tournament appearances, they're really going to never forget that. And our team overall just had an outstanding season. And that hurts them right now, but tomorrow, Sunday morning, they'll wake up and they'll realize they finished with a second-place trophy, and there's a whole bunch of schools in the state that would like to be in our shoes.
You've been around soccer for a long time. How does this game rate just in terms of the quality of a game compared to some you've seen?
It'll be nice to watch it on video. I'm sure the fans were, I mean, what a back-and-forth game both teams have on opportunities. I thought their St. Francis was very well coached, so We hope that we regroup the returning players, and I know they've got a lot of returning. Maybe we can do this again next year. Different result.
In Chatham at Glenwood High School, the local fans gathering to celebrate the Lady Titans' second trip to the state championship in 7 years. Despite taking runner-up in Class 2A, Glenwood ends the season with a record of 20 wins, 5 losses, and 2 ties on a squad with just 3 seniors. So as you can imagine, Bree Gardner, Kara Moody, and Abby Julin expect big things out of the Lady Titans in the future.
Me, Abby, and Bree are leaving, but they definitely have strong people coming in and a lot of returning starters, and I think that they're going to be really good.
I hope the girls win it all next year. I feel like we would contribute even though they're not there because we helped the girls go this year and get all that experience.
I'll be coming back and watching a lot of games, and you know, I'm leaving it all to them. They're going to do very well. I think they'll win state for sure.